In this video, you're going to learn how you can promote your app through Facebook ads. We'll start by looking at the different objectives that you could have, app installs and app engagement, and some of the details around that. Then we're going to look at a couple of companies who've had some amazing success using Facebook app ads. You can see some huge installs here and also some great results in terms of engagement. So we'll look at exactly what they did in order to achieve those results. Then we'll move on and look at some of the setup process, including registering your app and installing the Facebook SDK, giving an overview of the process for those two steps. And then finally, we will look once again in the Ads Create tool and practically how you would run one of these campaigns. So let's start in the Facebook Ads guide here and looking at the two different objectives that you would have with app marketing. The first objective that you probably have if you have a brand new app is to drive app installs. And you can see that you can place these ads on the Facebook mobile app. You can even do it on the Facebook desktop app, Instagram mobile app, and you can put it on Instagram using carousel ads as well. The format of the ads are probably going to be pretty simple. And the objective and the call to action button is really just going to be install now. Now that looks pretty normal to what we've seen before. What is slightly different is what happens once people click here. They will be brought to either, they will be brought to the Apple App Store or the Google Play Store, depending on their device, so that they can download the app directly. Now, the rest of these recommendations, you can have a look at them in more detail yourself, but here is one interesting thing to note, that your star rating from the Apple Store or Google Play Store will automatically show on your ad. And so that is great social proof that you can pull through from those app stores to show on your ad. So your first objective is going to be to get people to install your ad. And if you're running a campaign, this is probably the first step. Next step then is to drive more app engagement and get more activity on your mobile app. It's not enough just to get people to install it. You might need to drive more engagement once they have downloaded it. And really a top tip in order to achieve this is to create a custom audience of people who use your mobile app and then reach them with an ad encouraging them to take specific actions. Now, in order for you to create this custom audience, you will need to have the Facebook SDK set up, and that is the equivalent of really the Facebook pixel for a website. You want to set it up for those same reasons. So now that you understand that you have two objectives, apps installs and app engagement, let us have a look at some of these case studies to see how businesses are piecing this together and getting some amazing results. So what we have here is a brand new takeout ordering app. And you can see that through Facebook ads, they were able to get 15,000 app installs over 4 months and over 70,000 app interactions. So they have installs plus the interactions. Now the name of the app is 10bis, Israeli's largest takeout ordering app. And in your country, you've probably seen an equivalent to this, really linking a lot of restaurants together and enabling people to order food through one single app. Now, if we look down here at their solution and how they achieve their goals, this is pretty interesting. What they really did was start by using interest and demographic targeting with mobile app ads. And they wanted to reach groups who were most likely to download and use their app, such as those with known interest in food and restaurants, single people and younger age groups. So that is some smart targeting through interest and demographics there. You can see that people who already are interested in food and restaurants are probably going to be interested in their app. Single people who maybe don't want to cook and prefer just to order, or younger people who may be more likely to get takeaways more often rather than going out and buying a lot of food, etc. So some interesting targeting there just to note down. Now, once they had driven some app installs using the interest and demographic targeting, they really went on to step two here, which was to drive more app engagement. And they had another campaign where they used custom audiences, as we've said, to target ads, to target people who've already downloaded the app And these ads encourage them to place orders using the app call to action button. And they did encourage that activity by offering special promotions for restaurants in their local area during this campaign. So two quite very strategic ways that they first build installs and next drove those engagement by offering those special coupons. So that was the 10 B's. Let's have a look at another case study here, which is PlaySpace. This is quite an interesting one because they were really focused on driving app engagement for Brazilian women gamers for one game that they had. And interestingly enough, this is a Spanish company, a game studio, and they were very focused on driving this growth overseas. So you can see some of the results here. 2x increase in monthly users, 3x increase in revenue, 50% increase in paying players, 10x greater efficiency, reach efficiency than TV. So you can see a lot of these results here are more focused on the app engagement rather than app installs. Now coming down, we can see that once again, they targeted specific demographics, women of a certain age, relevant interests, and really did it to promote this Loco Bingo game. Then they use the custom audiences. Once again, you can start to see a pattern here. This is really key. Custom audience of existing players encourage them to come back. Here's the interesting part that they showed these people a video tailored to the Brazilian market. So obviously in Brazilian Portuguese, showcasing new game features through a series of carousel and app install ads. So that's an interesting tactic that they used to really show new features to encourage people to come back and download the app. Now that you've seen some of those case studies and understand practically what are some of the strategies that you can use, let's look at some of the steps in the setup process. So if you want to start using app install or app engagement ads, the first step is to register and configure an app. Now I'm not going to go through all of these steps. I don't have an app myself, but the key things that you need to do are to set up a developer account. You also need to create your new app in there. The outcome of that process is really to create an app ID. Once you've got that app ID, you can install it into your ad account, and then you're pretty much ready to go. However, you probably do want to set up that Facebook SDK so that you can do things like measure installs. Without the Facebook SDK, you won't be able to do that, and you won't be able to set up those custom audiences for improved targeting and measure in-app conversions, etc. So those two steps are absolutely critical. Now looking at finally at the ads create tool, how do you set these up? You can come in and select your campaign objective as app installs. Then once in here, you need to add in your app. Now I've just set one up as an example here. So that's the first thing that you'll need to do. If you haven't registered your app, that won't appear. Then you go through the rest of the ad set setup as normal. Your audience, your placements here, your budget and schedule, etc. Setting up the format is pretty much as normal. You can choose a video, image, etc. And the rest of the setup process is pretty much the same. The key thing that I wanted to show you is that you can't move further in the campaign unless you've got the app set up. And that's why you need to first register your app. So now you have a good understanding of app marketing on Facebook. I'll put the link to these two resources in the resources section of this lecture. So if you are going ahead to market your app, you can just follow these steps to get set up.